Right, so this is the end of winter 1702, beginning of summer 1703. What I plan to do for the next few terms is just go through the terms at my normal speed without all the commentary, because if you've been watching the videos up to this point, you've probably got a good idea of what I'm doing anyway. And I'm not expecting anything exciting to happen in the next few terms. In fact, I'll speed this up. So we'll just run through, because I think Prussia's not going to be ready to go to war until sort of 1705. Because I want to get the canister sorted out. I want to be close to adding some field artillery to my armies. And also I've noticed that both Saxony and Poland are upgrading the towns in the areas I intend to attack, so I'm quite happy to let them spend the money, invest their own money in upgrading those towns before I capture them. So I'm just going to run through the next few turns more or less at my normal pace without all the talking, and it'll give you an idea of how fast a turn would normally take. Here we go, end of turn. The Berlin fortifications are finished. That's my troops built. Check the government. Oh, we've got a new guy. Is he any good? No, he's not better than anybody else. Policies. Oh, no change there. Trade's been interdicted. That's because that Russian fleet blocked the Ottoman port. Nothing I can do about that apart from going to war with Russia, so I'm not going to do anything about it. We just lose a bit of income, unfortunately. Check to see if there's anything new that I can build. No, there isn't. Right, recruit some more troops. A few more infantry. And a bit more over here. Nothing special there. Okay, so that's the end of that turn. Off we go. You see, it's quite fast once you get in the swing of things. Admittedly, if something suddenly happened, I'd probably have to slow down. What I didn't do was check the diplomacy tab. I might do that in this turn, just to check it. See if there's anything new I can swap research-wise. Ottoman Empire, try to sort that port. Oh, they sent some ships in, that's good. We might get our trade back if they manage. Oh, that fleet's going the wrong way. Go and sink that Russian fleet. I want my... Oh, he's gone off anyway. That's all right. Good. Right, should have our trade back with the Ottoman Empire now. Even at the fast speed, it takes quite a while to get through these endermen. You can turn this off so you can't see the AI's moves, but I actually like to watch just to see what's going on elsewhere. Oh, someone's offered the peace treaty. That's interesting. Okay. Single payment. Okay, I'll have a peace treaty with the Barbary States. Not sure what use it might be, but why should we be at war with them? They're not doing us any harm. It's not very ethical, is it? But never mind. Making peace with pirates. What is Prussia coming to? Right, these are the end of turn reports. We've got a new rake. So I'll move him somewhere useful. Where can I move him? Where can't I see? I can't see what's going on in Vienna. I'll move him down here. Okay. Our canisters complete. Good. Right. Quick check. What can we build instead? Anything worthwhile? I might go for physiocracy. No, what am I doing? Priority is military research. Get some bayonets. Dear idea. Right, we've got our peace treaty with the Barbary States. Military technology is complete. Built our canister, we've researched our canister, I've started doing ring bayonets. So that's sorted. All our farms are built, the Royal Observatory in Berlin's built. Lots of new troops, and we've got an amusing CAD for one of our people. Oh, well, fair enough. Right, check the government. Neither of those people are particularly good. Everybody in the government looks like they're doing the right thing. No problems on the taxation. Oh, Great Britain is blockaded now. What's going on? How do we keep losing trade? This is the trouble with warfare. Keep losing trade. Yep, France is blockading London. Nothing we can do about that. We're not at war with France. We can't sink their fleet. Britain will have to sort it out by itself. Good news, Ottoman Empire's back. Right, quick check on the diplomacy tab, see if we can get any additional technology. Oh look, France is still looking for physiocracy. Let's offer them, I'll offer them canister shop. Sod them, they're not having that. Are they gonna be reasonable? No, they're not. Okay. Great Britain. Oh, Great Britain has it. Perhaps that'll be a bit more reasonable. Let's see if they'll accept. No. Well, I'm prepared to offer Great Britain a bit more for that. Go. Oh, they are. Now they're happy. They want the military alliance, so. Okay, I'll enter into a military alliance with Great Britain. Ottoman Empire. We upset the Ottoman Empire earlier. I'll see if they'll give me improved grenades now in return for everything. No, they're not happy. It should be the faster way of doing this. So, a bit long-winded. Okay, nothing else on the diplomacy side, I don't think. We are now in an alliance with Great Britain. Not something I would normally recommend, but in this instance, Britain is very friendly. They already seem to be at war with France and many other people, so hopefully they're not going to drag us into any new wars, and we are not required, we're not obliged to join in the ones they're already in, thank goodness. Although, of course, they would not have made us popular with France or Poland. In fact, I think you get a negative factor. No, it doesn't actually show any negative factor for being friends with my enemy. Would have thought it would, but never mind. Okay, so that's the diplomacy tab done. Research, we're still going on the ring bayonets, that's fair enough. Okay, investment wise, we can now upgrade our artillery cannon factory to an ordnance factory, which will give us proper field guns, which is what I'm after ideally before we go to war, but possibly shortly afterwards, because I'm not going to hang around much longer now, I don't think. So we'll build our cannon factories in both Brandenburg and East Prussia, so we're ready for that. I noticed that the balance in my treasury is starting to drop now. That's undoubtedly because of the size of the army. So we can't hang around much longer. We're going to have to use this army because it's costing us money, so it has to be put to good use. I'm just going to continue to increase the size of it. And then I think we're going to be going to war very shortly. So that's the end of winter 1703. We'll just go through one more turn. And then we'll do a bit of a strategy check and see if we're ready to start this war. I'm trying to free its ports up. Poland stripped all of its troops out of its northern provinces, which is interesting. That's going to make our lives easier. It might be time to actually invade West Prussia. Oh, Russia's attacked, blockaded, well, raided that port, in fact. That's really annoying. The Ottoman Empire seem to be moving their fleet far too far away, leaving Russia just to pick on them at will. Not a good idea. Complete. I'm going to end the video here, and next video we'll go on to 1704 and consider whether the time is right for Prussia to go to war. See you in a while. Well, that's 1703 complete. I'm going to end the video here, and next video we'll go on to 1704 and consider whether the time is ripe for Prussia to go to war. See you in a while.